Welcome back, my dear students, in online classes of mathematics. I hope you all have done well in your unit test exams, right? So we were in unit 4, that is multiplication, right? In this chapter we have finished so many topics already. Like first we have seen simple recall of multiplication, that is one digit multiplication. Then we have seen two-digit multiplication and their problem solving. And also we have seen three-digit multiplication. So now we will do the problem solving of three-digit multiplication. Okay, it is given in your page number 106 and 107 of your test book. Okay, so here so many problem solvings are given, but we will solve only four. That is question number 1, 3, 6 and 8. Okay, we will solve these four questions only. So let's start doing. Okay, so our first question is question number 3, problems on multiplication. First question is, a bookshelf can hold 189 books. How many books can be kept in 289 such bookshelves? So we have to find out how many books are there in 289 bookshelves, right? So first we have to write number of books in a bookshelf are 189. Then number of books in 289 bookshelves are equal sign, and then you have to write 189 into 289. Multiply both the numbers, both are 3-digit numbers, right? So first what we have to do? First take the ones, that is 9. 9 into 9. 81. So what we have to write here? In 81, we will write 1 here and 8 will go up with carry, right? So 9 are 81, 1 here and 8 carry. Next, 9 8s are how much? 72. So 72 plus 8, how much? Here 8 is carry, so we have to add 8. 72 plus 8 is 80. So put here 0 here and 8 will go again carry. 9 ones are 9. 9 plus 8, 17. So the multiplication of 9 is over. So put here 1 cross mark, because the multiplication of 9 is over, right? Next is 8. Multiply with 8 now. 8 9's are 72, right? So put here 2 and 7 will go up as carry. 8 8's are 64. 64 plus 7, how much? 71. So put 1 here and 7 again will go as carry. 8 ones are 8. 8 plus 7 is 15. Okay, right here 15. Now, multiplication of 8 is also over and 9 is also over. So put 2 cross, 1 for 9 and 1 for 8. Next number is 2. Now multiply 189 with 2. 2 9s are 18. So 8 here and 1 carry. 2 8s are 16 plus 1 is carry. So 16 plus 1 is 17. 7 here and 1 again will go up. Now 2 ones are 2 plus 1, 3. So multiplication of all the 3 numbers is over now. Now add all the numbers. Now see only up to here and add the numbers. 1, 2, 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 8, 16, 1 carry here. Now 5 plus 1, 6 and 7, 7 plus 7, 14, again 1 carry here, 3 plus 1, 4 and 1, 5. So 54,621 books are there in 289 bookshelves. Okay, like this we have to solve 3-digit multiplication.
Next is question number 3. We will not do question number 2. We will do question number 3. So, from an orchid, 5673 baskets of orange oranges were sent to the market. Each basket contained 205 oranges. Find the total number of oranges contained in all the baskets.
Okay, so you have to find how many oranges are there in all together. Okay, so first what we have to write, what are the datas we have? Number of oranges in an orchid are 5673. Number of oranges in a basket are 205. So total number of oranges are, how you will find out? Multiplying 5673 into 205. Okay, so for what we have to do, first we will take the first number, that is 5. 5 threes are 15, 5 here, 1 carry. 5 sevens are 35. 35 plus 1 is 36. So 6 here and 3 carry. Then 5 sixes are 30. 30 plus 3, 33. So 3 here and 3 again carry. 5 fives are 25. 25 plus 3, 28. Multiplication of 5 is over. Put a cross down. Now multiply with 0. So whenever we multiply with 0 to any number, we will get 0 only. So 0 multiplied by 3 is 0. 0 multiplied by 7, 0. 0 multiplied by 6, 0. 0 multiplied by 5, 0. Right? Next, multiplication of 0 is also over and 5 is also over. So put 2 cross. Right? Next is 2. So 2 threes are 6, 2 sevens are 40 and 1 here 10. 2 sixes are 12. 12 plus 1, 13. So 3 here and 1 again carry. 2 fives are 10. 10 plus 1, 11. Now, what you have to do? Add these two numbers. Now, don't see this side only. You have to add these three numbers. So 5, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 8 plus 4, 12. 2 here and 1 will carry here. Now, 3 plus 2, 5 and 1, 6. 1 and 1. So, we will get this much oranges. How much? 11,62,965. The total number of oranges are 11,62,965.
Your next question is, question number 6. 547 students appeared in the exam. If one paid rupees 275 as examination fees, what was the total amount paid by them?
So you have to find out how much total amount they all have paid together. Okay, so first what we will write? Number of students, 547. Each student paid rupees 275. So the total amount paid by them is 547 multiplied by 275. Okay. Now again multiply with first number. 5 sevens are 35. So 5 here and 3 carry. 5 fours are 20 plus 3. 23. 3 here, 2 again carry. 5 fives are 25 plus 2. 27. Multiplication of 5 is over. Put across. Next is 7. 7 sevens are how much? 49. So 9 here and 4 carry. 7 fours are 28. 28 plus 4, 32. So 2 here and 3 carry. Now 7 fives are 35. 35 plus 3, 38. Now multiplication of 7 is also over. So put 2 cross. Next is 2. 2 sevens are 40. 1 carry. 2 fours are 8 plus 1 is 9 and 2 5s are 10. Now add these numbers. 5, 9 plus 3, 12, 2 here, 1 carry. 1 carry, right? Then 7 plus 1, 8, 9, 10. 10 plus 4, 14. So 4 here, again 1 carry. 9 plus 1, 10 and this 10. 20. So 0 here and 2 carry here. 3 plus 2, 5 and 1 will come down. So how much total amount they have paid? 1,50,425.
Now last question from this page, question number 8. A laborer works 8 hours daily. He works for 25 days in a month. How many hours will he work all together in a year?
So here he works 8 hours in a day. Okay. So in 25 days he works 25 multiplied by 8. 8 5s are 40, so 0 here and 4 carry. 8 2s are 16. 16 plus 4 is 20. So, in 25 days, he works 200 hours. Okay, so this much is all for today's video. Only these 4 questions you have to solve in your copy. Okay. So till then, take very good care of yourself and solve these 4 questions in your notebook.